staying in Frankfurt. State lawmakers are putting in overtime on two bills that could prove crucial in the coronavirus response and shift power away from the governor. LAX18's Carolina Buczek has tonight's big story at 5.
Things are moving very quickly here in Frankfurt this year, especially when it comes to pandemic-related bills. You can tell the Republican lawmakers are motivated to get this done fast. So much so that they actually adjusted their schedule and they're coming in tomorrow and early next week. Normally, lawmakers don't meet on Saturdays, but they're motivated to get some of these bills into law. The big one, of course, is Senate Bill 1. It tackles 39A, which gives the governor his emergency powers. The bill has already passed out of the Senate, and today it went before a House committee.
Senate Bill 1 is not a partisan bill. It's an institutional bill.
The bill's sponsor says this bill essentially sets a 30-day limit on the governor's emergency orders. And if the governor wants to renew the order, lawmakers must be called in. So take the mask mandate as an example. Governor Andy Beshear has extended it several times now, but if Senate Bill 1 was in place, he wouldn't be able to do that unless the legislature came in and agreed. So Republicans in favor of it say this gives other people a say in the decision-making process.
This gives the ability for all corners of Kentucky to be able to come to the table and to be able to have a little say-so in an emergency order that might dip into every part of their life, from their freedoms, from the economy, to their livelihoods.
But Democrats don't see it that way. They believe this bill is an overstep on the executive branch. They say it's important for any governor to have the power to make quick decisions during an emergency. And they believe the emergency orders, like the ones we've seen during the pandemic, have saved lives here in Kentucky.
We are lucky that we have the lowest numbers of any of the surrounding states. And that is largely because Governor Beshear has kept us safe. Are there things that could be done differently? Yes. This is not the way to do it. I vote absolutely not today.
But that no vote wasn't enough. The bill passed in committee and now it moves to the full House. And another pandemic bill close to becoming law is House Bill 1. It gives businesses and schools the ability to stay open during a pandemic as long as they are following CDC's guidelines, meaning businesses won't have to follow Kentucky's own rules. And that bill passed the House yesterday and is close to a vote in the full Senate. So it's possible some of these changes may happen as soon as tomorrow. Now, of course, the governor can veto these bills, but the Republicans have super majorities in both the House and the Senate, so they have the numbers to override that veto. In Frankfurt, Carolina Buczek, LAX18 News.